I'm Della Cruz. My guests today belong to the Newark Circle of Sisters. They are the largest network organization in the Brick City with over 5,000 members. The group was created by women for women.
It gives me an opportunity to be a part of a sisterhood. Someone who can understand where I'm coming from, where I'm going, understand the struggles, and it just really just helps. You know, you feel like you're not in this by yourself. That's why I love being a part of Newark Circle of Sisters.
Being a part of NCOS means, to me, support. I feel like we are a powerful community of women that support one another through our greatest ambitions, tough transitions, and I really haven't found
being part of a unity of motherhood, sisterhood, the community. You know, the head of the family is the father, but the family comes from the mother. So just to be a part of such greatness.
I love that line, the family comes from the mother. Joining me here in studio today, Kalina Berryman, founder, Daniqua Matias, co-founder, Robin Lee Butler, vice president. Welcome to all of you ladies.
Thank you for having us. We're so excited to be here to talk about NCOS.
Tell us about NCOS and your founders.
Yes, so the Newark Circle of Sisters is a women's empowerment organization in the city of Newark, and we are governed by the principles of sisterhood, service, scholarship, celebration, and support. So the goal of it is really to bring the women of Newark together who are really running things, you know, and making things happen in every facet of the community so that we can feel the love that comes from sisterhood. And so we are 4 years old and going very strong.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Tell me more behind the history and the mission of NCOS.
So the history, it came about in a really random way. One day we were planning for an event that Daniqua was having, and I just put up a Facebook post that said, shout out an amazing woman in the city of Newark.
Aww.
And the comments were tens long.
Wow.
Of women just shouting each other out. And two things stood out to us from that. One was that there were so many women we didn't know who were doing incredible things.
Mm-hmm.
And secondly, that love was something that really made us all feel good. So Newark Circle of Sisters is like that love coming to life.
And that love is much needed. Who are the NCOS board members and their role?
So Kalina and I are the founder and co-founder. Robin is our vice president. Najla Fareed is our events coordinator and all things wonderful. Yasmin Young is our scholarship chair. Tamika mm-hmm. Darton Thomas is our membership chair.
Yes.
And treasurer. No, me.
Oh, I'm sorry.
There's another one. She forgot that.
Yes. Tamika is our membership chair and secretary. Monet Daniels co-founds the scholarship committee with Yasmin. Mm. And then Monique Bonilla Winstead is our other board member. So we all just bring different venues and lights to the organization, and it's a really strong group.
Yes. Is that what you look for in your board members?
Yes.
Each of you with your own unique mm-hmm. ray of light.
Yes.
Yeah, and women who are just good to the core.
Yes.
Because it's very important that NCOS be a sacred place mm-hmm. where women feel nothing but goodness.
Mm-hmm.
And so when we were going about picking our board members, we all kind of look and think whenever we have an opening, mm-hmm. you know, who is somebody who is really amazing and just full of love and really believes in sisterhood? So that's how we come up with our board. And our board is dynamic. I'm so proud of our board.
Yes, absolutely.
So proud of our board.
How many board members do you have?
Nine?
Yes.
Nine.
Mm-hmm. And tell me all about these monthly meetings.
So we have some amazing, great, fun parties.
Yes.
We call them general meetings, but they're really parties.
That's right.
Yes,
okay.
And it's a chance for all the NCOS members to get together mm-hmm. in a central location and just kind of have some fun, whether it be a little activity that we do, or we just tell everybody the updates, or that we're getting ready for an event. And these women come out. Sometimes they're the same women. Sometimes they're different. We always have mm-hmm. a different group come and talk about things, and we just fellowship.
What kind of events do you have?
Well, we have the Newark Circle of Sisters Women on Fire event. We have Mom Talks, which mm-hmm. is a creation of Robin. We have the event where we do the clothing swap.
Mm-hmm.
We kind of swap out, you know, bring some cute stuff in and swap it out with each other. We have the vision board party. And then we also have events to raise money for our scholarship, which is at the heart of our organization.
Go back to this vision board party. I like the sound of that.
Yes.
Encourage each other with your dreams.
Yes. Absolutely.
Yes. So our board member, Najla, she came up with that. Mm-hmm. And we just bring magazines to our one general meeting and a bunch of scissors and glue and stickers and things mm-hmm. that make us feel pretty and nice. Mm-hmm. And then we put it all over these big yeah. poster boards and we explain to each other what our dreams are. Mm-hmm. And out of that, sometimes other sisters come forward and say, I can help you with that. Mm-hmm. We can send you to someone who knows how to do that mm-hmm. or here is a class or I'm teaching a class.
Right.
So there's always something networking going on.
Yeah. And the beautiful part about it is that you know, we're helping to formulate our visions, but there are women in the room who can help you mm-hmm. to make that vision come to life. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So our meetings are attended by heads of organizations, by, you know, women who do media, women who are involved in politics, who write, so many different kinds of women. So if your goal is to write a book, there's likely a woman in that sisterhood who's already done that.
Let's talk more about these connections mm-hmm. people make at these meetings. That
sounds
fascinating.
Yes, definitely.
Keep going.
So I think the central message of our meetings is that all are welcome and that mm-hmm. we're here to support each other.
That's right.
We had a meeting where there were a couple of new people there and one lady said, you know, I wasn't too sure about it. There are a lot of organizations in Newark and when it's women getting together, I didn't know how I was going to feel, but at the end of the meeting, mm-hmm. she felt the love. She felt that she belonged. And it wasn't anything extraordinary that we do except for just cherish each other and let each other be who we are.
That's
we all
right.
come from different backgrounds and we celebrate that diversity. We mm-hmm. celebrate those different skills and ideas that you bring to the table. So, and that's what we put forward as an organization.
I love the way you all tap into the resources and
yes.
gifts that
mm-hmm.
each member has. Mm-hmm. You know, tell me about your lecture series as well. Mm-hmm. Does that tap into that too?
Oh yeah, yeah, because there are so many women who are experts in different areas. And even on our board, you know, we have business owners. We have women who, you know, like we said, do media and different things. So we have a lecture series where you come and bring what you know mm-hmm. and help to empower another woman. Because when you support a woman, when you empower a woman, you empower a family. And so we make sure that we are always giving our sisters some information that can help them to plan the course of the rest of their lives.
So you're networking within the family.
Oh yeah,
absolutely.
Yes, yes. Mm-hmm. And we have a thing, if you need something, you call on your sister first. You hire your sister. You think of your sister. It's very intentful.
I want to hear about these examples. Any other examples you have of women? You mentioned the one woman who said she just was just loved mm-hmm. the whole atmosphere and the camaraderie.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Give me a few more examples mm-hmm. of what women gain from this.
Yeah. Well, there are organizations where boards, you know, outside of our organization, where if people are looking for board members or people to get involved, they come to NCOS and kind of fill out the room. People have gotten jobs. Mm-hmm. You know, yep. we all hire and support each other. So people will tell us, like, you know, we made that connection at the NCOS meeting, and now we are doing this together.
Wow.
So it's a central place, and there's not many spaces like that in the city of Newark, where it doesn't matter who you are, what your background is. Everybody's equal in that room. Everyone is important. And when you walk in, you understand that the purpose is to make stronger relationships.
I can guarantee you're going to get a lot of phone calls out of this. Like you get back to the next generation with the scholarship.
Yes.
Yes.
Tell us about that.
Mm-hmm. So the scholarship we've started about 4 years ago. Mm-hmm. And throughout the history, we've raised over $6,000.
Congratulations.
Thank you. We've been able to send graduates from high school or even women attending college currently to help support them. And the central focus is that it's called the Sisters in Service Scholarship, right? So you have to be willing to or demonstrate that you're giving back to your community. Because no matter what we do, we always have to pay it forward. That's how we continue to build up our community. So women who are graduating high school, there's a minimum GPA required, and then an essay that they write about their service to the Newark community.
That is just fantastic. Kalina, Daniqua, and Robin, thank you, Robin Lee. Thank you very much. Next, we will talk with a scholarship winner from the Newark Circle of Sisters. Be right back. We are back with members of the fantastic Newark Circle of Sisters, Kalina Berryman, founder, Daniqua Matthias, co-founder, and Jennifer May, the NCOS scholarship winner, is joining us in this segment. Lovely to have you here, too.
Thank you.
Now, before we went to break, we were talking about your scholarship.
Yes.
When do people need to apply, And what kind of characteristics and criteria are you looking for?
So the scholarship application comes out about February of every year, and we are looking for women who have a really deep love for Newark and who are already giving back to the community in some way. There's a GPA requirement of 2.75. So academics is important, but the heart of the scholarship is that these young ladies are already planting a seed of service within the community. So a lot of our scholarship winners, like Jennifer, who won a couple of years ago, they are founders of organizations in their teenage years.
Wow.
They are creating advocacy campaigns. They are feeding the homeless. These young people are doing it in the city of Newark. So we want to honor them, and we understand that college is a struggle for Newarkers. There are a lot of issues in Newark, poverty, crime, different things that, you know, we are aware of. And so if we can help a sister who is pursuing higher education just a little bit, that means a lot to us. So that's what we try to do it.
Jennifer, what did that scholarship mean to you, and what did you do with it?
Well, it meant a lot to me, and because I needed to buy books, I used half of it during the first semester and half of it during the second semester. I was smart with my scholarship.
Good
it was
for
a
you.
Big amount of money, so I was really, really smart with it.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
That's exactly what I did with it. I paid all of my books with it.
Where are you studying?
I'm studying at Rutgers University, Newark. I'm actually a rising senior.
Congratulations.
I'm studying public administration and legal studies.
And what would you like to do when you graduate?
I would like to go to grad school and then law school.
Yeah,
law
she's
going
to be a lawyer.
So you'll have that in the group,
yes,
too.
And
I'm sure you already
have
a couple.
Small role in that, and that makes us so, we're so proud of Jennifer. We keep in touch, and I've watched her do some really amazing things over the years, because I work at Rutgers University, so I get to see her go through her journey.
Now, what caught your attention about the way she pays it forward and gives back? Mm-hmm. Do you have an organization?
Well, in high school, I was a part of this organization with Shayla Oliver, Assembly Speaker Shayla Oliver.
I love Miss Oliver. She was on my show years ago.
I also am a part of YMS. I was when I was in high school. And I also fed the homeless a lot. I just do that personally. Like, every month I go and feed the homeless. And that's pretty much it. I tutor for free a lot in Newark. And in Newark in high school and University High School, there was this group called Sister to Sister. It was a mentorship program where the older kids would mentor the sophomores and 7th through 8th grade. So anyone from sophomore to senior would mentor 7th and an 8th grader. We would tutor them. We would take them out. We would sort of like the Newark Circle of Sisters, this mm-hmm. mentorship program
yeah.
for sisterhood.
Mm-hmm. How important is mentorship in helping you prepare for college and what's ahead in the future?
I think mentorship is important in general. In order to succeed in life, I think you need many, many mentors.
Yeah.
Many, many people from different, especially your field sometimes,
yeah.
but many mentors from different fields who get it, who understand what you're going through.
See, and I know you all love the fact that she gets it.
Yes.
Therefore, that's why you honor so many people with your Women on Fire awards.
Mm-hmm.
Tell
Absolutely.
Us about that.
So Women on Fire kind of started when I was running for the school board at the time. I did a...
You're a busy lady.
and a mom.
Yeah.
But at the time, we were doing a fundraiser, and I wanted to honor women who weren't necessarily well-known,
mm-hmm.
kind of like those silent heroes that you never really get to celebrate, but
exactly.
who definitely deserve a pat on the back.
And who would never ask for it.
And who would never ask for
exactly.
it. Who were just so humbled
yes.
and thankful for the experience.
Definitely.
And so we did it that year, and at the same time, Kalina was coming up with this concept of Newark Circle of Sisters. She had did the Facebook post, and so we said, since we're going to have this organization, we'll roll this event right into the organization
mm-hmm.
because it was so successful the first year.
Mm-hmm.
In the second year, Alicia Keys' song, Girl on Fire, came
yeah.
out. And, you know, that was just the song of the summer,
yes.
that bass drop, you got excited.
Yes.
So we chose that as the theme song, and then that ended up being the theme of the awards, Women on Fire. And since then, it's just been branded that way. We have the programs that have the burnt pages. We have the promo videos that we do with the honorees' pictures kind of burning and flame. And it's probably... at least to me, one of the most anticipated awards
mm-hmm.
of the season.
And it must mean a lot to your honorees.
It
what
does.
They say to you?
It does. It does. And we are blessed to have on our board an event planner, Simply Plan to Perfection, Nazra Free. She'll be up in the next segment. So it's one of the most beautiful spaces,
yeah.
too. Definitely, like the colors were so vibrant. When the women walk into that room, whether they're being honored or not, you feel important and you feel loved. And when you look around the room and you see the attendees are amazing, just as amazing as the honorees. It's an exciting time. And yes, like Daniqua said, it really is one of the most highly anticipated events in Newark, I think. Definitely.
I can see why. Mm-hmm. Kalina, yeah. Daniqua, and Jennifer, thank you all for being in this block. Our chat with the Newark Circle of Sisters continues right after the break.
Thank you.
My guests belong to the Newark Circle of Sisters. Robin Lee Butler is vice president. Nejla Farid is the events coordinator. Samantha La Velez is a member of NCOS. And welcome to you, ladies.
Thank you so much. Thanks for having us.
Okay, I want to talk about this one thing that I found fascinating, the vision board.
Yes, the vision board. It's a hit. We had it this year for the first time. And what we do is invite the sisters to come out and just put your vision on a board. And this way, you can be reminded of things that you want to do, your goals, the things that you want to do in life, and it keeps you on track. For instance, waking up in the morning, go to your vision board. Okay, what do I want to do? You know, you just keep putting it out there, and people just don't realize if you keep it focused with that
you will act accordingly.
Absolutely.
To make it happen.
Like the law of attraction.
Right.
You know, the secret. You know, I don't know if, you know, a lot of people know about that, but, you know, that secret, if you watch that, it'll tell you a lot about the vision board. But you just put your vision out there and just keep going with it.
Use your energy to make it happen.
Absolutely.
And you believe in that, too.
Oh, absolutely. I actually attended the event with my daughter and I brought my best friend. And I shared with the group, you know, that during that time I had just got off of work and I was kind of exhausted and I almost didn't go. But something pushed me to go there. And I grabbed my daughter and I took my best friend and we went. And when I left out of that meeting, yes. You know, we didn't even have to talk throughout the whole event. It was just the energy, the synergy in the room just left me feeling amazing. Like I felt invigorated. And that was very important. My daughter, she's 16. And it was important for her to see the things that young women can do and how we can uplift each other and how we can be there for each other. So that was one of the main reasons why I took her with me.
I love that. You also have something called Mom Talks.
Yes. So we've done it once before, and we're going to try and keep it going. It was an idea of mine after one of our general meetings where women just sat around, and those of us who are mothers shared sort of our battle stories and our favorite memories. And it occurred to me that there are a lot of mothers who don't know that they are not the only ones. So what happens to you as a mother can also happen to a bunch of other mothers in our circle, and why not get together and talk about it? So it's sort of a cross between what I consider the vagina monologues and the TED Talks. The women come up and we just tell our stories and we tell our truth and hopefully educate and comfort other women at the same time.
Laughing and crying together.
Absolutely. You all were talking about a membership pin.
Yes.
That's so special to you.
Yes. Well, I'm a member and I'm a platinum member.
Oh, congratulations. What does that mean?
Well, it's basically the highest membership that you can have within the North Circle of Sisters. But what it means to me personally is really a contribution to my community. Before I join any organization, I always look at its board members and who started it and what are they grounded in. And one of the things that I know about these amazing ladies is that we have a commonality, and that is our love for the city of Newark and its citizens. And so that was one of the reasons why I joined the Newark Circle of Sisters. Again, like when I go to the meetings or any of the events, I always leave out feeling motivated. And that's very important for us to be able to get together and have a place where we can go and feel loved and supported. And celebrate it. I think that's a big deal. We all celebrate each other in different ways. And that's very important, especially in the city of Newark, where a lot of times in the media you hear a lot of negative things, but there's so many, you know, different spotlights in the city of Newark, and we need to make sure that those things are known. And Newark Circle of Sisters is definitely a bright light within the city.
That's part of your future plans, isn't it?
Yes, absolutely. Absolutely.
Go ahead and tell us more about them.
About the future plans. Okay, what we have coming up, next event is called Divas and Donations.
Oh.
And what that is going to be held in November. We come together and we invite the community to bring gifts so we can give them out in December for Christmas and Kwanzaa to the community. So that will be the next event. And then we're working on the Newark Circle of Sisters Family Expo for next year.
Sounds like a lot of fun.
Yes. So that will be inviting vendors to come in. different workshops, entertainment for the whole community and family.
So what is the mission and message you want people to walk away with from this interview? You do a lot of things, like you said, to inspire and empower.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Well, as a member, if I can say anything to anyone, is if you're looking for a group, a support group, and you could be a mother, you can be a sister, a hard worker, a business owner, and if you're looking for a place to go where you can feel supported, where you can learn from one another, North Circle of Sisters is definitely a place to be.
And you all want to add to
that? Okay, a shoulder to lean on, an ear to listen to, because we have so many people that need that. You know, just to listen to the person will just uplift you.
Yes.
Exactly. And Robin?
Come out, have fun with us.
She loves her fun. She and I need to get together. Thank you very much, ladies. Robin Lee, Nejla, and Samantha, we appreciate it. And you can find out more about the Newark Circle of Sisters on news12.com/features. And, of course, this program will also be posted on my Facebook page. I'm Della Cruz, New Jersey. The spotlight is on you. Thank you, ladies.
Thank you.